of you who saw our film on Young's Brewery Shire horses will remember Robert, the largest horse in the brewery, and somewhere behind him is Gary Bean, who was then the Young assistant farrier in Young's workshop. And today's a very special day for Gary because he's going to officially become an apprentice farrier. Right, Gary?
Yeah.
And over in the workshop, I know his father and Mr. Young, the owner of the brewery, are waiting to sign the important papers. And his first assignment is going to be to help Shoe Puff, who is just getting to know Robert rather well, I think. Should we go over and see if your father's there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, Gary, I'm sure this is the day that we've all been waiting for, and you certainly in particular, when you were going to sign your indentures.
Yes, sir.
You joined us, how long ago? Last August, you came when you were 15.
Sir.
And now you're 16. You're going to sign these papers, and you'll be apprenticed to become a farrier, and it's 4 years.
Sir.
A long, hard slog, but it'll be worthwhile, I can assure you, at the end of it.
Sir.
Well, we've got the company seal here, which is over 100 years old in itself, so we'll put the seal on first. And then I'm going to ask you to sign it, and then I'll sign it for the company, and then we'll ask your father to sign it. All right?
The important papers are signed and sealed in triplicate, and Gary is at last a fully fledged apprentice. His first job is to remove Puff's old shoes. This he does under the watchful eye of the chief farrier at Young's. Perhaps you remember him from the Shire Horse film, Mike Orgill. If a shoe has been carefully and firmly put on, it needs very careful and firm removal too. They always work on the left side first. Shoes are replaced in pairs, and the back ones are slightly less rounded than the front ones. It's worth remembering that Gary's used to dealing with those huge Shire horses, as he's been helping Mike for nearly a year already. Just what an apprentice is allowed to do is entirely up to the boss, and Mike believes in teaching a little at a time and thoroughly.
Now, what has to be done now?
Well, Mick's going to chop the feet down now, just trim them up to get ready for the shoes to come in.
You don't do the chopping down?
No, not yet.
That comes later, does it?
Yeah.
Come on then, Mick. Fire away.
What's there, isn't it? Come on.
Come on, buddy.
Touch of the manicures now.
Oh, yeah.
Manicure it may be, but the huge cutting tools and files need skillful handling so as not to cut too deep. And also, they have to avoid damaging the delicate frog which runs from the heel to the centre of the hoof. What happens, the feet grow?
They're growing all the time, like your fingernails, you know, it's the best way to explain it, I suppose, you know. And of course, you have to chop them down. If they get too long, they break.
And then the shoe comes off with them?
Well, yeah.
The new pair of shoes were hand-forged especially for Puff by Mike. You'll probably remember that you can get a much snugger fit by burning the shoe onto the hoof before putting the nails in.
Come on. Come on, Cop.
Ooh, doesn't it smell strong?
Oh, you can get used to this after a little while.
That's almost an exact fit. Now, how on earth... You didn't measure it before you started making the shoe, did you?
Well, I had a look at him. I wouldn't have cheated. I wouldn't have a look at his foot. Well, I didn't measure it, no. Come on.
That's all your years of experience, I suppose.
Yeah. Oh, boy. There we are.
Just a few final adjustments were necessary. And then the shoe's plunged into water to cool down before it's finally nailed into place. Can we compare it with one of... Oh, we've got one over here. Compare it with one of the normal ones. Look at that. You're ready to shump. Shoe.
We're ready to do him now, yeah. Come on, Ed.
you giving it another filing away? You just
taking off this here and one or two ridges, you know, and mark what he's picked up off the floor. And it just gets the chew down on his foot nicely.
I remember you said from when you were shoeing the shire horse that the burning doesn't hurt, but that doesn't hurt either, does it?
No.
Pauline was telling me that the better the horse's foot, in a sense, the better the horse. In other words, if you've got a horse with not good feet, you haven't got a horse. Do you agree with that?
Oh, yes. I say look after the bottoms and the tops to look after themselves.
What if there's trouble in the feet of any of your horses? Do you call in the vet or do you look after it yourself?
Well, generally, we look after it ourselves unless it's too bad and we can't find out what the trouble is. Then we have a vet in.
Do you think that in these days of mechanisation that the farrier will go out altogether and they'll have machines to shoe horses?
Oh, they'll never get machines to put shoes on. They've got them to make shoes, but they'll never get them to put shoes on horses, I'm afraid. Thank you. Oh, there to say, I should say.
The apprentice usually does the last but very important job of filing down all the rough nail heads. File the nails completely flat, do you?
Yeah, on the inside it's most important because, like, when he walks and trots, he might catch it on his other leg.
All right.
So they've got to be, like, flush with the foot.
All done?
Yeah, that's the lot now.
Mark, great. Pauline will be delighted. Oh, hang on. Happened to be wearing a 4 for a boy badge today.
Right.
Special for you.
Right, thank you.
Thanks a lot, Gary. I'll take her back. Feel better? You're
going to
shoe Robert now?
Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
And if 4 years seems a long time for the training, I bet you'd be very glad if you were a horse.